Hello and welcome, myself Rehan Ali, and today in this tutorial I'm gonna show you how can we print these triangle patterns. So without any further ado, let's get started. First we'll write our code to print this solid triangle pattern. Here, for making it more visual as a programming point of view, I drawn these lines here for separating each rows and columns, and you will get this idea very soon. I'm using these words like rows and columns because we already had discussed these terms in more details in our square patterns tutorial. If you have any doubt and confusions, you can watch my first tutorial of this series in which I have explained all the things and also written codes for printing different types of square patterns. You can find the link at the top right corner, and I also include the link in the description of this video. Alright, so enough talks, let's begin with this pattern. Here, these blue lines are used for separating each columns, like this is column 1, this is column 2, and this is 3, and so on. And similarly, these yellow lines are used for separating each rows. Now, our outer loop will run 7 times as num rows are nothing but the 7 here, and this value of row val will vary from 1 to 7 in this case. As you can see here, row val is changing from 1 to 7, and also for each value of row, inner loop will run different number of times. For example, when row val is 1, this inner loop will run 7 times and prints these 7 stars. But for row val 2, this inner loop will run 6 times, and for row val 3, inner loop will run 5 times, and so on. Means each time the value of column is varying, or we can say that this value is decrementing by 1 for each value of row. As for the first row, inner loop is running 7 times, and this value is similar to our num rows. We can use value of num rows as our initial value for printing these stars. Let's see this through the code. Here, first we need to declare some variables as like these. Variable num rows is used for defining the number of times the outer loop will run. Row val for each value of row and col val for each value of columns. I use this getDataType variable pattern symbol to set the symbol to be printed. You can change this value to any very symbol to print pattern of that particular symbol. Now we'll write our outer loop to print each rows. I use these printf functions including this line break character to make our output looks like this. Here, as you can see, each row is printed on its own line or on a new line. Now for printing these stars here, I will use one extra temp variable and assign this variable the value of num rows as like this. And after printing each row, or for each time when this loop completes its execution, we'll decrement this temp value by 1. This allows our inner loop to run as for the first row, this temp value will be 7, means for the first time, this inner loop will run 7 times, and for the second row, this temp value will be 6, and this allows our inner loop to run 6 times. Because before going to second iterate of the outer loop, we are decrementing this value by 1, and again for the third row, temp value will be 5, and so on. Now let's run it, and yeah, we get our expected output printed here. But here, in this example, I want to make some improvements. Instead of using this temp variable, what I can do is, I can run this loop in reversed order to get these values as 7, 6, 5 and so on till this value becomes 1. And use this row val for running our inner loop as like this. This loop again runs 7 times, but this time it will run from 7 to 1. And now we get the same output without using any extra variable. And why this is working? Because row val for the first time will be 7 as we are initializing it with the num rows. Then after running this inner loop 7 times, row val get decremented instead of incrementing as in our previous solution. So now this value will be 6. Then we run this inner loop 6 times and again decrement this value by 1 and so on. Alright, so this solution will be our base for next 3 patterns. Now let's see the second pattern. Now here in this pattern, we only need to print these parts, and other than these parts, we just need to print spaces. We already had seen this in our previous examples. So for printing this part here, as here value of col val is 1 for each stars, we can drive our first condition as like this. Similarly, for printing these lines, we have value of row val as 1, as we can clearly see it here. Therefore, our second condition to print this part will be as like this. Now for the third part, as this value is nothing but our row val, for example, we print this star. This star when col val and row val is same. Here when row val is 6, col val is also 6. Also to print this star, col val is 5 and row val is also 5, and so on. Means our third condition will be row val is equals to col val. Now these are all the conditions that we require to print these parts here. Or for printing hollow triangle, let's include these conditions in our code. This is the code we written earlier for printing our solid triangle. Now we just need to add these conditions here to make it hollow triangle pattern. This condition will look something like this. Here we are using this OR operator for separating our multiple conditions. This OR operator allows if block to execute when either of these conditions are true. You can find some link in the description of this video to learn more about these operators. Now run it and see the output. We get our output as this because we haven't printed anything for the else part. Here, as we know that other than these values we have to print spaces. So I simply add one printf function here that will be responsible for printing spaces when this part gets the chance to execute. Now when we run this code, we'll get our required output. This output is nothing but our hollow triangle. Let's see the next pattern. Now as this output is very similar to our hollow triangle pattern, here only these parts are added. So for printing this pattern, we just need to add some more conditions in our hollow triangle to print this new pattern. So here we'll use our previous code with including some extra conditions. Let's see what are those conditions. As these both values are nothing but the half of the numbers, we can use our both extra conditions as like this. We already had used these conditions in our previous examples many times. It simply means that when we divide our numbers by 2, it will return value 3, as value of numbers is 7 here, but our requirement is 4. Therefore we add one extra into these returned values. Let's write these conditions in our code. So here this is the code that we written for printing our previous pattern, that is nothing but the hollow triangle. Now I'll add these two more conditions here. Here I'm using one extra else if block to make it more readable. But you can also include these conditions in this if block also by separating them with OR operator. Now let's run it and see the output. And yeah, this is nothing but our third pattern. Now let's see our last pattern. Here also we'll use our previous code and add some more conditions to print this extra part. As you can see here, when we subtract our core value from the row value, we get value 3 for the each row. For example, here for printing this star, value of row value is 6 and value of call value is nothing but the 3. Now when we subtract this value from row value, we get our output as 3. Similarly for printing this star, row value is 5 and call value is 2. Now again subtracting call value from the row value, we get 3 only as a result. We are doing this because at the end we need some conditions to print this part here. So according to these results, we can build our last condition as like this. As we already seen it in our previous example, dividing row value by 2 returns 3. So this condition will be valid and that's it. Now we just need to include this one extra condition in our previous code to print this last pattern. Let's see how. Here I include this condition in this else if block. We can also use one another else if block for this condition if we wanted to, but I just include it here. Now let's run it and yeah, this is the code to print our last pattern. You can find the source codes of these patterns written in C, C++, Java and Python from the description of this video. And yeah, if you like this tutorial, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. And also if you are new on the channel, please subscribe the channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to never miss out any incoming videos like this one. And that being said, I hope to see you in the next video.